Hello friends, this is Preeti Rajput. Welcome you in my today's grammar lesson. Friends, today we are going to deal with phrases and clauses. What is mean by phrase and what is mean by clause, that we are going to see. This is very commonly asked question. So we will try to understand what they exactly are and what is their function in a sentence. See, here two examples I have written. My best friend and Ram is my best friend. These both are a group of words. Can you identify which one is phrase and which one is clause? Let me give you a hint. A clause is a group of words which has subject and verb combination. And phrase is a group of words which doesn't have subject and verb combination. Can you identify now? See, Ram is my best friend. Ram is a subject and is verb. See, here subject and verb combination is given. So it is clause. And my best friend, it doesn't have any subject and verb combination. So it is phrase. Now we will see it in more detail. See, now we will start with phrase. What is phrase? A group of words that makes sense but not complete sense is called a phrase. Here my best friend, we get sense but not get complete sense. This is phrase. Phrase is a group of words. My best friend. Three words are here. It's a group of words. No subject verb combination. Here we do not get any subject and any verb. Again, doesn't contain a finite verb. It does not contain a finite verb. In my last video, we learn about what is finite and non-finite verb. In this phrase, we can find verbs that is non-finite. But finite verb we won't get in phrase. Again, fourth feature of phrase is doesn't have complete meaning if it is used alone. See, if I use alone my best friend, we don't get complete sense. But same phrase, if I have written in a sentence, Ram is my best friend, we get complete sense. Means phrase is a group of word which has sense but not complete sense. It doesn't stand alone. It cannot stand on its own. We will learn it in detail after seeing some examples. Here are four group of words. See, the traveler sat under a tree. To play chess is not easy. Third one is Mrs. Mehra is a woman of great intelligence and four children like flying kites. These all are group of words and they are sentences as they have complete sense. See, the traveler sat under a tree. They are sentences because they are having complete sense. But what about the underlying expressions? See, under a tree. If I try to hide this part, the traveler sat. Only if I read under a tree, are we getting complete sense? No. In the same way, to play chess, this is also a group of word, but it does not have any subject and object, subject and verb. Mrs. Mehra is a woman of great intelligence. This is complete sentence with complete sense. But only this underlined part. It does not have complete sense. Children like flying kites. This flying kite is also phrase. Because these underlined expressions do not have subject verb agreement. And this is group of word. See, what are the features we have seen in phrases? Phrases are a group of words. These are a group of words. No subject verb combination. Just see underlined parts. They do not have subject and verb. Again, doesn't contain a finite verb. They do not contain finite verb. We are talking about the underlined parts. See, under a tree, there is no finite verb. To play chess. This play is verb, but this is not finite verb. This is infinitive, non-finite verb. Of great intelligence, no doubt there is no verb at all. Children like flying kites. Flying, this is also verb, but this is not finite verb, this is gerund. So phrases are group of words. There you can find more than one word. Group of words which do not have subject and verb combination. There is no finite verb and they cannot stand alone. See, phrase is a group of word which is used in a sentence as a unit. Now,
as we know that in sentence, word is act as a noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb. Then in what way phrase act? See, phrase is also act as noun, adjective, verb, preposition, and adverb. How? Just see. Now we will see the types of phrases. First is noun phrase. What is the function of noun? Noun is a naming word. In the same way, the phrase is used as noun. That is called noun phrase. Let us take some examples. I love reading comic. In this underlined expression is phrase. In this, reading is a noun, gerund. So reading is a main word here in this phrase. So reading comic act as noun. So this is noun phrase. To understand people is very difficult. To understand people, this is also a phrase used as noun. We like to listen good music. To listen, this is infinitive. To listen good music, this is phrase used as noun. See, I love reading comic. This reading comic is used as object in this sentence. Even to understand people, this is used as subject. And subject and object, these are nouns. To listen good music, this is also used as object. Once again, it is noun. So noun phrase is a phrase used as noun. And the main word in this phrase is noun. Now second one is verb phrase. Verb phrase, there is also a group of word. In that group of word, main word is verb. Main verb. And there is helping verb also preceded by them. I have been reading the book since last week. Have been reading. This is phrase. And reading, this is the main word in this phrase. And reading is main verb. So this is verb phrase. My mom takes care of me. This takes care. Takes is main word in this phrase. So takes care is verbal phrase. Your outfit is looking quite appropriate. Looking is main verb here. And this is the main word in this phrase. And there is helping verb also. Here also helping verb have. So verb phrase is a phrase where there is verb is a main word and they are used as verb. So this is verb phrase. Now moving towards another phrase, that is adjective phrase. Adjective phrase. What is the function of an adjective? Adjectives are words which used to describe noun in details. In adjective phrase, they are also act as adjective. And the main verb word in the phrase is adjective. Now see, we purchase a steel almira. Almira is noun. And steel is adjective used for almira. We purchase an almira made up of steel. Here, made of steel, this phrase replaced in place of steel. Both made of steel and steel, they are used to describe almira. This steel is used to describe almira, this is adjective. And this made of steel, this phrase is used to describe almira. So this phrase is used as adjective. Look at this adjectives and adjective phrases equivalent to them. See, a fearless man. Man is noun and fearless is adjective. Same adjective I used in phrase, a man without fear. A man without fear. This is phrase. Stone walls. This stone is adjective. For this stone, wall made of stone. Wall made of stone. This is group of word. This is adjective phrase. A kind man. In place of kind, a man of kind nature. This is group of word. This is phrase. Use as adjective. So this is adjective phrase. In the same way, Indian goods. Goods made in India. This is also adjective phrase. An experienced teacher. A teacher with an experience. So these are adjective phrases. Is it clear? Adjective phrases are phrases used in place of adjective. Use as adjective. Now moving towards adverb phrase. Adverb phrase. Adverb phrase act as an adverb. and the main word in the phrase is adverb. What is the function of an adverb? See, adverb we use to describe action. She acts cleverly. Cleverly shows the manner. So this is adverb. She acts in clever manner. This is also describe an action. But cleverly is a single word, adverb. And in clever manner, this we replace in place of cleverly. So this is adverb phrase used as adverb. Another example, I search for my book everywhere. Everywhere, this is adverb of place. I search for my book at every place. At every place, this is group of word used as adverb. This is adverb phrase. You can say adverbial phrase also. So, at every place, this is adverb phrase. Some examples I have written on the board. Undoubtedly, undoubtedly is adverb. And without any doubt, this is adverb phrase. Group of words. Early, at early hour. Hurriedly, in a hurry. These are phrases. There, at that place, soon, in a short time. Cautiously, with caution, etc. These are examples of adverbial phrase. Now it is time to see prepositional phrase. What is mean by prepositional phrase? Prepositional phrase starting with the preposition. And in that phrase, main word is preposition. See, they stood by the river. Here, this phrase is starting with preposition. The store at the corner sells cake. This phrase is also starting with preposition. We climb up the hills. Here also up. The sun rose over the mountain, and here over is preposition, and this is the main word in that phrase. And see here, river, the store, hill, mountain. These are the subject and object for the preposition. Now let us move toward clause. What is clause? See, before going ahead, just read that examples. My neighbor is a man of great wealth. And another example, my neighbor is a man who owns great wealth. See, the underlined expressions are having same function. Of great wealth, it is describing to the man. And another expression, who owns great wealth, that is also explaining to the man. So, one is phrase and one is clause. As just we saw that, phrase is a group of words which has sense but not complete sense. Of great wealth, which has sense but not complete sense. It doesn't have subject and verb. And another expression, who owns great wealth? It is having subject. See, who is subject and owns has finite verb. It means of great wealth, it is phrase, and who owns great wealth, this is clause. It means it is very clear, clause is a group of words that form a part of a sentence and has a subject and finite verb of its own is called clause. And this is an example of clause because it has subject and finite verb. So one more distinction we are having. A phrase doesn't have finite verb. A clause can have one finite verb, and sentence has at least one finite verb. It means if we define the sentence, it says sentence is a group of words which has complete sense, and clause is also group of words. Sometimes it may stand on its own, sometimes it depends on other sentence. So, phrase is a group of words who doesn't have finite verb. It is a part of a sentence. With this example, it is clear ki phrase and clause both are the parts of sentences. In detail, clause is a group of words. It has subject and verb combination, and it can have complete meaning by itself. This is clause. Now, we will see the type of clauses with some examples. Now we will see the types of clauses. There are two type of clauses, main clause and subordinate clause. What is mean by main clause? Main clause is a group of words which has complete sense. And a subordinate clause is a clause which depends on other part of sentence to get complete sense. It means subordinate clause doesn't have complete sense by its own. See, you were in the party. You were in the party. It has complete sense. So this is main clause. But when I said, when I came home, when I is subject and came is verb. It has subject and verb. But if I say, when I came home, then what? It lacking entire thought. But when I join these two sentences, when I came home, you were in the party. Now I get complete sense. See, if this part I am going to hide, you were in the party, I get complete sense. This is called main clause. And when when I came home, it doesn't get complete sense until it doesn't take the support of another part of the sentence. When I read complete sentence, when I came home, you were in the party, that time I got complete sense. So this is also clause. But this doesn't get complete sense by its own, so this is subordinate clause. See, this is main clause, this is subordinate clause. It is called as independent clause because it has independent sense. It doesn't depend on others. But this part is depend on this part, so this is dependent clause. So, main clause is called independent clause and principal clause as well. And the subordinate clause is known as dependent clause also. We will take some examples to make it clear. My dad laughed when I told joke. See, when I told joke, my dad laughed, it has complete sense. But only if you read when I told joke, are you getting complete sense? No. But when this part is taking support of this part, this get complete sense. So underlying part is main clause and that one is subordinate clause. See friends, main clause and subordinate clause is joined with one conjunction. See, I saw a child who was crying. I saw a child, it has complete sense. So this is main clause. Who was crying? If I read alone, it doesn't have complete sense. This is subordinate clause. It is clause but. Respect others or other will respect you. See, both are main clauses. If I read respect others, it has complete sense. I get complete sense. Others will respect you. That is also having complete sense. Both are main clauses. Mahatma Gandhi, who is known as father of the nation, is my favorite hero. See, this subordinate clause here come in between of the clause. Mahatma Gandhi is my favorite hero. This is main clause. Who is known as the father of the nation? This is subordinate clause. This is dependent clause. Aman will be late to work for he has a dental appointment. See, Aman will be late to work. It has complete sense. It is main clause. He has a dental appointment. This is also main clause because this is also having complete sense. I like coffee and Mary like tea. These both are main clauses and they are connected by the conjunction. Here, who is conjunction? Here, or is conjunction? Here, who is conjunction? Conjunction means conjunctions are words which are used to join two words, two phrases or two clauses. I box that words. These are conjunctions. They are used for connecting two clauses. See, but now we have seen one is main clause, one is subordinate clause. Third example, fifth example and sixth example, both are main clauses. It means in a sentence, there can be two clauses, more than two clauses can be there. Both clauses can be main clauses and somewhere one clause can be dependent clause and another one can be main clause. So these clauses we have joined with conjunctions. There are two type of conjunctions, subordinating conjunctions and coordinating conjunction. See friend, coordinating conjunctions are conjunctions which we are used to join two main clauses. I repeat, which we use to join two main clauses, that conjunctions are called coordinating conjunctions. Here, or, for, and, these are coordinating conjunctions. And subordinating conjunctions we are used to join subordinate clause to the main clause. Here, when, who, these are subordinating conjunctions. Now we will see the list of subordinating conjunctions and coordinating conjunctions. There are two type of conjunctions, coordinating conjunctions and subordinating conjunctions. As I said that coordinating conjunctions are used to join two main clauses and subordinating conjunctions are used to join one main clause and another subordinate clause. There are only 7 coordinating conjunctions. It is good idea to memorize that coordinating conjunctions and use mnemonic. That is fanboys. F stands for A and nor, B but, O or, Y at and S so. So fanboys, if you memorize this mnemonic, you will memorize all coordinating conjunctions. And remaining all are subordinating conjunctions that we use to join subordinate clause to the main clause. Coordinating conjunctions are used to join two words, two phrases and two clauses. That's all for today. I hope you understand what is phrase and clauses. Before leaving, just quickly revise this session. Firstly, we have seen phrase. Phrase is a group of words which has sense but not complete sense. There are 5 types of phrases: noun phrase, verb phrase, adjective phrase, adverb phrase and prepositional phrases. And another thing we have seen, that is clauses. Clauses are a group of words which has sense and complete sense it has. Sometimes it doesn't have complete sense, it depends on other part of the sentence, that is subordinate clause. There are 2 type of clauses, main clause and subordinate clause. They are joined with, 2 clauses are joined with subordinating conjunctions and coordinating conjunctions. Coordinating conjunctions, there are 7. You can memorize it by using mnemonic fan voice. And remaining are subordinate conjunctions. So friends, that's all for today. Try to solve the exercises based on phrases and clauses. I hope you understand this session. Thank you for watching me. Thanks a lot and have a good day ahead.